All right, so the presidential election, as we all know, we keep talking about it, is just a few weeks away. So is this the time to make some changes to your investments, or do you just leave things alone? Our dear friend Les Szarka from Szarka Financial joining us live now. Les, it's good to see you as always.
Hey, Steph, how are you?
I'm okay, thank you. So talk about this now. You know, the markets have been on this roller coaster. I mean, we threw in a pandemic during an election year. So much going on. So how do you think the upcoming election could affect all of this?
Well, I think it's going to have a huge effect on it. Normally, it's not that big of a deal. But I think this time around, there's such a huge difference, you know, between the candidates. I think we're already starting to see that. The last couple of weeks, we're seeing a lot of volatility in the markets. And then you throw on top of that the passing of Ruth Ginsburg now, which was just like pouring gasoline on it. So I think the effect is that the one thing the market absolutely hates is uncertainty. Mm-hmm. And that's exactly what we've got right now. And I think, you know, again, normally the difference between candidates isn't that huge. So if one wins versus the other, I mean, the country still continues on a, you know, somewhat of a similar direction. This time around, I think really, you know, there is a huge fundamental difference. And it's going to come down to is, you know, what do you think the federal government's focus should be on? Is it more of a, you know, economic agenda or more of a social agenda? And so I think the market's looking at this saying, well, you know, there could be a fundamental change in terms of, you know, what the federal government's role is, and they're just not sure what that change would be. So obviously it's causing a lot of anxiety. Our worst case scenario, frankly, is that, you know, come election day, you know, in the evening, we don't have a clear-cut candidate that has the majority of the electoral votes. And so if that's the case, and there's a couple of states that are, you know, going to have to delay because of the mail-in ballots or, you know, whatever the situation is, you know, we're not going to know more than likely who the winner is on November 4th, which is just going to feed into this anxiety that the market has. And all you have to do is think back to, you know, when Bush ran against Gore. I mean, it wasn't until late December that we knew who the actual winner was. I mean, we all remember those pictures of the guy with the glasses, you know, the hanging chads, you know. So yeah, hopefully that's not what we're setting up. Hopefully one candidate or the other has a clear electoral vote, you know, majority, so we can at least settle it, you know, that evening.
And looking at history and how when you look at when the party changes, then that does a lot too with correcting the market and maybe investments being down. So it's really interesting to see over time and over history how that does affect the economy.
Well, normally it's not the candidate themselves. Mm-hmm. You know, it's the policies that are set forth afterwards. You know, so it's hard to say, well, you know, if a Republican or a Democrat wins, the market will do X. Mm-hmm. You know, it really comes down to the policies.
Yeah, no doubt. All right. So should we be making any changes right now? 6 weeks to go before the election, or is this a time to just sit tight and let some things ride out?
Honestly, this would be a time where I'd probably be a little bit more cautious. I mean, there's just so much uncertainty. Plus, against passing of Ruth Ginsburg right now has just, you know, fueled the fire even more. And I think the market, you know, having come off of a huge run-up since March 24th, is going to look at this and say, you know what, probably better off just taking some profits and just playing it a little bit safe. And I think the average investor, there's more downside than there's potential upside. So I'd probably be a little bit more cautious going into the election.
Les, you're always that voice of reason for us and calm. Hmm. And I know throughout this entire pandemic, you have always been saying to me, Steph, when you look at these things and when the markets go crazy, they do correct themselves when you've got things like this. Although most of us, I think any generation alive right now would say they've never experienced anything quite like we're experiencing right now.
Yeah, this is a little bit different. And again, there are times you want to just kind of back off a little bit and just take it a little bit more cautious. And I think this is probably one of those times.
You got it. All right, Les, thanks as always. So good to see you. And hopefully we'll be seeing you in person here in studio soon. So folks, if you have any financial questions, some guidance, because right now we all have individual situations and the experts at Szarka Financial can really help you and look at your individual situation and make what's best for you and make your money work for you. And that's what we all really are working toward, that goal. Les Szarka, thanks so much.